Welcome students, today we will be discussing about fill algorithms. So first let us all understand what is this term fill is. Whenever we have discussed that we have to draw a circle or any polygon, whether it is a ellipse, triangle or a circle, what we have to do, we have to fill it also. Whenever we see any object on our screen, it is mainly filled. So till now we have only seen the algorithms to draw the boundary of these polygons or these circle and ellipses. Now we have to study the algorithms to fill them. How do we fill it? So we have a screen here. So in a screen we have just produced the boundary of a circle. Now we have to show it as a painted circle. How do we fill it? How it should look different from the rest of the screen. So for them, for that purpose only we will be discussing our fill algorithms. So there are three kinds of fill algorithms that we are going to discuss: scan line polygon fill, the second is boundary fill, and the third is flood fill algorithm. So we are going to see each of them one by one. So let us start our discussion with scan line polygon fill. Let's say we have a polygon like this. Let's say we have a polygon like this. What does scan line means? We are taking our scan line as on horizontal axis parallel to x axis. So if I am taking this scan line, it is y is equal to 1, this is y is equal to 0. Similarly, I am having next parallel line, next scan line as y is equal to 2. So what I am doing, I am just having all the scan lines which could be crossing this polygon. So let's say this is y is equal to 3, y is equal to 4, y is equal to 5, y is equal to 6, y is equal to 7. So these are called my scan lines. What we have to do for each scan line now, we have to find out the intersection points here, the intersection with the scan line and the edges. So we have edges of polygons intersecting with these scan lines. So we have to do this procedure. So let us discuss the procedure first, then we will formulate it in a theoretical way. So this is the point of intersection. These are the points of intersection here. We are seeing the points of intersection. They must be on some pixel value. Might be they are at 2, this is at 3, this is at 7, then this is at 9, this is at 10, this is at 11, this is at 15, and this is at 17. So what we have got now? We have got intersection points of polygon edges in respect to our scan line y is equal to 7. So the first step here is to, for each scan line, what we have to do to find intersection points. So we have found out the intersection points. Now the second thing is sort these intersection points on basis of x value. So these points could be, let's say, 2,8, this is 2,7, because the x is 2 and the y is 7. This could be 3,7, this is 7,7, this is 9,7. So we will sort them. They are already sorted, but just to make sure that they are in a correct order, we will just sort them, sort these intersection point on the basis of their x values. Now the third point is, we have to pair them. How do we pair them? We pair them like the first point, 2, 7, and 3, 7 becomes a pair. Then 7, 7 and 9, 7 becomes a pair. No matter where they are, we will just take two points and we'll just make pairing of them. So it's like that. We have got how many pairs? We have got, out of 8 points over there, we have got 4 pairs. The fourth step is to fill all the pixels which are there in between each pair. So in this pair, we have all the pixels which are there, we will fill them whatever is there, whatever pixels are there between these scan lines, we will just fill them. So similarly for here also, we will just fill these pixels and like that I will fill all the entire polygon with the in respect to the scan lines. So this is basically the very base case of our scan line polygon fill algorithm. Now let us see where could the problem occur if I have some certain type of a polygon. But do remember this thing, that you have to do things in this order. First we have to draw the scan lines to find the intersection points with the edges of the polygon. Sort them, sort those intersection points on the basis of x values. Then we have to pair them. We have to make their pair of each having two points. And then whatever pixels are there within that pair, we have to fill them or we have to color them. Now we will see a special case where there could be a problem . Let us have this polygon and I am drawing one scan line here and I am drawing one scan line here. Let's say this is my scan line Y and this is my scan line Y dash. So the problem occurs when I am encountering my scan line with the vertices. So there is a vertex here, there is a vertex here, and there is a vertex here on scan line Y and on scan line Y dash. So whenever there is a intersection of these scan lines with any vertex, there we have to be very careful in the sense of counting the number of intersection points. So let's compute for Y dash first. For Y dash, this is one intersection point. This is one intersection point. So there are two intersection points till now that we have got. What about this vertex? So this vertex will be again counted as how many points? This will be counted as 2 points. So there are 2 points. How there are 2 points? Because here this scan line is intersecting with two edges. So one is this edge and another is this edge. So it is intersecting, means it is touching two edges, so it will be considered as 2 points. Then we will make pair of the same point, that once the fill algorithm will work from here between this pair, and then it will work from this pair. Correct. Now let us look for Y. Let us look for Y. Scan line Y, I have got one intersection point here and I have got one intersection point here. Here also we have a case where this particular intersection point is touching two lines. But will I consider it as a two points? Will I consider this intersection point as two points or just one point? It will be considered as one point. Why it will be considered as one point? Because both the edges are in opposite direction of the scan line. So here is the difference. When I am dealing my intersection of vertices with the scan line, I have to check whether all the edges which are intersecting, which this scan line is intersecting, are in the same directions or in opposite direction of in respect to this scan line. Let's see, if I had considered them as two points, what would have happened? If I would have considered it as two points, then I would have 1 point, 2 point, and 3 point. So first point, second point, and third point. Then I have no way to make pair of them and to find out and have to fill the pixels. So this is why what we have taken, we have taken this as a one point. Because if they are in the opposite direction, that means it is just constructing one point. So it will be considered as one point. So if my lines are in opposite, if the lines on the intersection vertices are in opposite direction in respect to this scan line, the point will be considered as one point. While here, these edges which were intersecting on this vertices with this scan line were in the same direction in respect to this scan line. So this point was considered as this point was considered as two intersection points. So again, then we made the pairing of this thing, and again we made a pairing of this thing. So these are the cases which you have to consider while you are dealing with the scan line polygon fill algorithm. Now, what is the disadvantage of this algorithm? Is to find out the intersection points. How? First of all, I have to make scan lines and I have to find out the intersection points. Then I have to make pairing of them. I have to fill them. Correct? So, could there be any better way to find out the intersection points? The strategy or a better approach is incremental approach. What is this incremental approach? It is also called edge coherence. Let's see what this approach is, edge coherence or incremental approach. Let us understand the solution through an example. Let's say you have these two scan lines. Let us say you have these two scan lines, y and y dash. And let us take the coordinates here. Coordinates here are xk, yk. Let's say this is yk and this is yk plus 1 scan line. The coordinates here would be, let's say, xk dash, comma, yk plus 1. We know that here the coordinates are xk, comma, yk, and here the coordinates are xk dash, comma, yk plus 1. Where my yk plus 1 minus yk is equal to 1, because we are taking the scan lines on increment of y. So let's say if this yk was 2, my yk plus 1 would be 3. So my yk plus 1 minus yk is equal to 1. Now let us understand the incremental approach or the edge thing. Now let us understand the incremental approach or edge coherence strategy is, if let's say I have got one intersection point here along this line, once I know there is an intersection point, without even having a scan line there, I can compute the next intersection point. how I can compute? Let us consider I just had one intersection point here, and I can just compute all the intersection point above the line. How we can do that? Let us see. So what is the slope of this line? Let's consider this as a line. What is the slope of this line? The slope of this line is yk plus 1 minus yk upon xk dash minus xk. So what is my yk plus 1 minus yk is already 1. So my m is 1 upon del x. Okay. Or del x is equal to 1 upon m. Now, if I have to calculate xk dash, what would be my xk dash? Xk dash would be xk dash minus xk is equal to 1 upon m. Xk dash is equal to xk plus 1 upon m. So, this is how I can find out my next incremental point there. So now we do not have to, in this incremental approach, we do not have to just find out the points every time. What we have to do, we just know what is the first intersection point or what is the first vertices point on this line, and I can just go approach it till it reaches top just by keep applying this formula in a recursive manner. Let's say if I'm starting from this point, there was some algorithm, let's say here, okay, there was the first scan line which was available here. I knew the point is this, and then on this line, I can just go and find out the points using this formula. Similarly, I found out one point here, and similarly, I can go into this direction also. I can go into this line also and find out what are the incremental points available on this line till I reach this point. Similarly, here also, we can have one scan line here which would tell me a vertices here, and from here I can just increment using the similar kind of formula, and I can get all the points available. Once I have all the points available, I can just sort them on the level of each scan line, and I can just make pair, and I can just keep filling them. So this incremental approach or edge correlation example, edge coherence strategy is for finding out those intersection points in a better way. Once I found out those intersection points, I can just have them sorted based on the scan lines, and on the x-axis, I can just fill them. We just have to take care about the vertices case as we had discussed. Since we have seen the scan line fill for polygons, now let us see the scan line fill for circle and ellipses. Why we are using this scan line fill for polygons? Because they have a dedicated or linear boundaries. We cannot use scan line fill polygon algorithms for the curved surfaces. What we have to do? Now let's see, circle and ellipses are also curved surfaces, but they are simpler than other some structure like this. So let us see what is the difference, how we can do for scan line fill for circle and ellipses. We know circle is having symmetry, ellipse, this is an ellipse, let's say circle is also having a symmetry. So for circle, we know that if we have one scan line, it will contact only at two places. So if we could find just one place, if we could find just one thing, I can have other coordinate as well, and I can just fill all the pixels between them. So any scan line will cut circle maximum at two places, and if I know just one point there, I can, through symmetry, I could find the next point there, and I can just fill all the pixels between those two coordinates. Similarly, for the ellipse also, the scan line will cut it only at two places maximum, and once I know the one point, I can have the second point with me, and I can just fill all the pixels available between them. But for curved surfaces like this, we cannot have our scan line fill algorithms. for these kind of surfaces, we have a boundary fill or flood fill algorithm, which we are going to discuss in the next video.